Hi, happy holidays. This is the Urban Domestic Diva again on day two of our annual holiday bake-a-thon where my sister, my mom, and I, Mom, the original domestic diva, I learned everything from her.
Oh, thank you very much.
You're welcome. So now we're going to be making a very traditional cookie from my mom's hometown called
Struffoli, or honey clusters, or pignolata.
They're named many things.
No, but we call them Struffoli Naples.
So. Okay, which is Naples, Italy, where she's from, right off the boat. So she's going to show us how to make them, and they're pretty easy. And she uses just her work table as a place to kind of make her dough.
You could do this in a blender.
You can do it in a blender, probably the kneading hook, but she's old school and we like that. So we'll get right down to it.
Okay.
So we have
sugar,
2 cups of flour.
2 cups and a half.
2.5 cups of flour.
And then we're actually sharing the secret recipe.
Yeah, secret is it?
Mom's gonna start twitching.
Don't put that on the internet.
And you're mixing up
sugar.
A half a cup of sugar.
No, a quarter of a cup.
A quarter.
Of sugar.
I'm sorry, a quarter cup of sugar. All right, so we got 2 cups of flour, a quarter cup of sugar. Round it all up. Mix it all up.
And then a teaspoon of baking powder. Even I don't like to put too much. They puff too much.
They puff up too much, so just under.
Yeah, under a teaspoon. I mean, you could if you like them puffy. Then you mix all this together. And then I'm going to put my little shortening.
So this has been softened a little bit, right?
This is Crisco, so it's already soft. You don't have to.
Okay.
I have the butter flavor. In Italy, I used to use lard. So whatever. That's very strong.
Of course, while we're taping.
And then I'm going to put, you don't have to put liquor in here, but I like to put a little Galliano in it.
I like Galliano.
So you kind of mix the Crisco inside, another Galliano, and you put the eggs first. This is probably replacing vanilla. You can also put a vanilla in here if you want.
And we've had the eggs sitting out at room temp. We don't want them too cold. So you want to take them out a little bit before you start working to get the chill out.
I need the Galliano. Give me a tablespoon and then some of our flour to drink.
Mama wants it. Yeah, thanks. That's good.
Is that enough? Yeah,
that's
heavy enough pour for you?
Thank you.
You're not driving, are you?
Nope. I'm with you. We're
okay.
Baking.
Okay. And then you put it in here, Jack. That's okay.
And one for me.
Okay. It smells so good.
No. I'm gonna put it in the sink.
Mmm.
That's good. That is good.
What's nice with the Galliano in the dough is I think it brings a nice floral honey kind of flavor, which accents the honey glaze that you're gonna put on top of the finished cookies. So as you can see, she's working the wet ingredients in the middle and brings in the flour from the outside in and is kneading.
You may need more flour when you roll them. I mean, sometimes the eggs are too big and then you may need more flour to make it thicker than the original measurement. So, but it looks good.
So flour's been worked in. Has a nice bounce to it, nice and moist, but not too moist.
No, otherwise it's going to stick when you're going to roll it. Looks good. Do one more around, and then we are ready to cut it. All right, let's put all the stuff away. We're going to leave this like this. You could take the sugar out, Jackie, if you...
So clear out your area, and we'll show you how to cut and make the struffoli. A small piece. Roll it out.
Roll it out, and then you need the flour. As you're cutting them, it's going to be like a pencil thin. And don't worry if they break, because you have to cut them in small bites. And usually, sometimes you need the water. Let me grab some water. You just go like this, and then it's better to roll it so you wet your fingers a little bit.
Wow, you've never taught me that one.
Yeah, Jackie don't remember. She doesn't remember.
Okay.
And then?
You're using a really sharp small knife and some flour nearby.
So when you cut them, you have to throw them in there so they don't stick together. It doesn't matter, you know, it doesn't have to be perfect when you cut them, because they're gonna fry and they're gonna get double the size almost.
So it looks like a quarter of an inch.
And then you roll them into the flour
so they don't stick.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so here are all of our struffoli. Just set aside, tossed in some flour as we cut. And now the next part is to get your workstation ready near the stove. You have a pan of oil on a medium-high heat. And what kind of oil is this, Mom?
I'm using the corn vegetable oil that we fry.
Okay.
You can have 1% olive oil. It doesn't matter. As long as it's a vegetable oil. I don't like anything that has a lot of flavor.
Mm-hmm. So. You want a clean flavor.
Yes.
And then you have a straining ladle.
Yes, and then also a lot of paper.
A lot of paper for draining.
Yes.
And you're going to heat your oil up. It's got to be nice and hot to fry up the struffoli. Batches at a time. So we usually, when things get hot, it's been heating up for a couple minutes, we grab a little mini plate.
Are you watching me?
Yes, I am. Just kind of bring them over in a mini plate.
Because they
don't
grow.
And you do batches, because they do grow.
I'm going to see first if the oil is ready.
So you throw one in.
It's not ready yet.
No. It's going a little slow, so we're going to heat it up a little bit. But you see how they're kind of starting to puff up a little bit? So they're not quite.
Okay, I'm going to put one more. Almost.
Yeah, Mom adjusted the temp a little bit just to heat it up a touch more.
So they're going to cook really fast. Okay. Let's try one more. Yeah, almost. Yeah. So and then you put them all in. And with the... what do you call this? I call them scola. Pasta, scola fascia, drain spatula.
Yeah, so like a perforated spatula or draining spatula.
I call them dilatation in Italian. So.
And you kind of toss them around and loosen them up, especially if they're getting stuck together.
And they all cook really fast, so you have to be really on your toes. This one gets stuck a little bit. Mm-hmm. like a golden.
Yeah, if they're getting brown too fast or unevenly,
yeah.
You kind of want to control your heat.
Then have this closed so when you take it out to drain the oil, you're almost ready.
Beautiful. See how puffy? They're like little puffy.
Little pillows. Mini pillows.
Wonderful. And you drain them and you work in batches.
Make sure you get all out so this way they don't burn. Don't leave anything behind.
How you're going to work in batches and just continue on until you've got them all browned up and draining. And then you cool them down and we'll...
I'll push this over to the side because I have more paper on this side to drain the oil.
And that flour kind of foams up, right?
Yeah, it's because there's a baking soda inside and it makes a lot of foam. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it has
the
much
leavening,
foam.
Right.
I changed the oil, but right now I think we are okay. I don't need to do that.
So as you go, you're gonna things might get too foamy and weird.
Yes.
And thick. Does the oil get thick?
No, not really. It's just because too much foam, and then you don't see when they get brown.
Ah, it's harder to see. Okay. And that's when you would change the oil. All right, well, we'll continue cooking the rest of these, and then we'll show you the final steps. So we're going to finish off the struffoli. We have in a saucepan about 16 ounces of floral honey.
I'm going to stir it then, and again, I'm going to get a spoon to the bowls.
Okay, so we're heating this up on a medium-low heat, actually. You're going to thin out the honey. And, you know, this is where actually you can get kind of interesting. We have just a regular floral honey, but you can experiment with different floral honeys. There's a lot of different kinds out there. And if you want more of a floral flavor, you could definitely buy more of like a rose honey. I've even seen lavender or chamomile honey. That would be nice. So Mom is looking for, if you hear all that clattering, that is a spoon. A draining spoon. Right.
So I gotta drain them.
So she's thinning out the honey. Meanwhile, our struffoli have been...
Yes. And then I have to prepare the... Let's get on the sunny side colder.
We're going to have a bunch of these in a tray. So while she's doing that, I'm going to help Mom put some liners in a tray. We're going to work in batches in our thinned out honey. Toss them around. Meanwhile, you want to move fast there, but you're going to have your little paper cups. Hopefully they're all festive looking. And carefully, because this is going to be hot. Right, Mom? You said
yes, because
the foils get
the foil
really,
hot
really hot.
Because the heat is on the honey to keep it melted. So if you have a glove, if you get hot, you could wear it, like a mitt, you know, a kitchen mitt. I'm so used to it that I don't need it, but it gets hot.
You're moving pretty fast. So just kind of ladle them in there and let them cool. And you don't want to let them cool too fast, because then you're going to
put some sprinkles.
Decorate them with some sprinkles.
Or sugar or whatever they want to put.
You want them to look festive. And you want want to do it before they're too, so...
So they stick.
Yeah, you need them to stick.
Because it sticks in.
Don't those look yummy? They are. There's a wonderful sense of, like, floral, sugar. The kitchen smells really nice. Okay, I have to help Mom, so I'm going to go now, but...
This is what they look like.
Yep. From Naples to here. Mm-hmm. Happy holidays.
Buon Natale.
Buon Natale. From the Urban Domestic Diva and family. Bye.